Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Qatar. Here you see me today dressed in the traditional Arab dress of a jellaba and keffiyeh. And this was kindly given to me yesterday by an eminent Iraqi businessman. I'm sorry, a Qatari businessman, who kindly gave me dinner and presented me with this dress at dinner and asked me to try it out today and see what it was like. It's very comfortable. But there is nevertheless a serious issue being discussed here at Qatar, which is to what extent are we going to continue to wreck the world's economy, and particularly the Western economy, by introducing measures that will have no great climatic effect. Now, I have tried, and tried quite hard, to get into the meetings which a few years ago at these conferences we would all, as observers with UN accreditations, have been allowed to take part. Allowed to sit in, allowed to listen, allowed to interview and interact with the delegates. All of that has more or less entirely stopped. The one meeting I tried to get into yesterday, in order to hear directly what the delegates were saying and what the conclusions were, they cancelled the meeting without any announcement. We were left there for an hour with nobody telling us what was going on. Today, the United States was supposed to hold a press conference for its chief negotiator, Todd Stern. At the last moment, that was cancelled without any explanation. And the impression one gets from this is of a gradual withdrawal of the UN and of the world's governing class from any interaction with the ordinary people, whom they nominally, but no longer actually, serve. And so instead, I went to the various fringe meetings, and I went in particular to one organized by an outfit of young people from the United States, very well funded, and this time very well dressed, who said that we faced a crisis because the climate was warming at an ever-accelerating rate, and that Tropical Storm Sandy was caused by mankind. I said to them, no, it wasn't, and there's been no global warming for 16 years. The figures appear not to add up. Even if there were going to be as much warming as they said, it would still be impossible for us to do anything cost-effective about it, because it was so much cheaper to let it happen and adapt later. And the reply when I said that on all measures there has been no global warming for 16 years was, but there's a consensus. Well, the consensus, as it happens, is that if you take an actual measurement, and that is what has been done, and it shows what I've said, then that is the consensus, like it or not. They are misinformed, as many here in Qatar are. Thank you for watching. Thank you.